Hey, I'm Kenneth Wajda. I'm a professional photographer here in Colorado. Welcome to another one of my weekly photo chats about gear, my experience with gear, you know, real world use. So today I'm going to talk about, this is an old Nikon FM. Has a half leather case on it. I picked it up from a local photographer who was selling out some stuff of his in a garage sale. And I think it was only like $100 or $60. It's $60, I think I want to say. $60 for the body. And I put a 20mm 3.5 lens on that I already have. And this is one of those cameras that lately I've been taking around as a point and shoot camera. Because with a 20mm lens, I can set exposure for any place I go inside. If I'm going to sit in here, I can set the exposure for a 125 at f2.8. I know I got a perfect, well, it's only a 3.5 lens actually. I can set the exposure for a 60 at 3.5, and I know I've got an exposure that's going to work. Anything I pointed at is guaranteed to work. And it's a camera that hardly needs focus with a 20mm on it. And you know me, I like to get into things. I like to get into close when I'm photographing groups and people and friends doing things. I want to be in there with them. I don't want to shoot with an 85 or a 105 from a distance. I want to be in there with them, and I want to feel what it's like to be sitting with them and experiencing what they're doing. If they're having a laugh, I want to have the camera close to that. So if I go outside and I put this at a 250 at f11 for 400 speed film, I can shoot this all day long without even worrying about exposure, and focus hardly matters. Everything's in focus all the time. It's a 20mm lens. You just have to make sure it's focused at least 3 feet, and then everything's in focus. So this is a great walk around point and shoot camera. And I have a special affinity for the FM. It came out before the FM2. It was a camera that only goes to a thousandth of a second instead of 4/1000ths of a second. I don't use those high speeds all the time with film. I do with digital when I shoot out the car window. But if I'm shooting this, I'm usually shooting family things. If I'm shooting film, I'm not usually shooting street. I've come to terms that I don't typically shoot street of strangers where I need to shoot more quantity with film. I might take a film camera and I end up shooting digital. And I use film for capturing moments of my world that is my close world, my family, my friends, things that are special to me. And so if I'm going to a car show, I'm taking a digital camera. I don't know those folks. If I'm photographing my friend who's going to be at the camera at the car show, I'm taking a film camera. And to pick up a Nikon FM, that's a sweet little mechanical camera, needs no batteries to run. It's the camera I started with at the newspaper back in the late 80s, so I'm really familiar with it, and I have always been a huge fan of it, probably because of some nostalgia. It's got a simple meter where I've always said, as long as I'm not pointing at windows, which there are windows surrounding me, as long as I'm not pointing at windows, I'm pointing at my subject and there's no real super bright spot behind it. And I get the zero and the plus to light at the same time. The way it works is if the zero is lit, that's supposed to be the correct exposure. Zero and plus is a half a stop over. And then plus is a stop or more over. So I'm always trying to get a zero and a plus up at the same time because I want everything to be about a half a stop over. And I've photographed many photo assignments with this, with that zero and plus. I even had a gentleman come up to me after I did a photo shoot back in the newspaper days, and he said, "Do you think those will come out?" And I said, they always come out. The camera's working. The film is working. I know how to make a picture with it. And the photo chemistry is working. Why would it not come out? There's an old phrase that we often would use in the film photography days. I wonder if it'll come out. I wonder how it'll turn out. There's no real wonder. The film isn't inconsistent. The camera isn't inconsistent. The lab isn't inconsistent, unless you're going to the drugstore. But if you're using your own lab or if you're doing it at home, there's nothing inconsistent. Yes, it's going to come out. It always comes out. And if you want an inexpensive camera to walk around like a point and shoot, put a 20mm lens on at f11 to an outdoor barbecue. You can shoot all day long without even hardly doing anything but lifting the camera and taking pictures. Because it's a point and shoot camera at that point. The 20mm lens lets you get that close to everything, and everything's always in focus at such a wide angle. And I would highly recommend it. If you're looking to get into one body that doesn't have a lot of battery dependency, which I'm not so sure it's such a big deal. There's plenty of batteries out there and you can always keep an extra set. But if you're really interested in one body that's all mechanical, it only uses a battery for the meter, so you can always guess exposure. And if you buy from a local photographer, you might be able to get the story of where it's been. This one is so clean, it felt like it was one that he kept for a backup and didn't use much. And again, it's one of those cameras that the FM2s are pretty much skyrocketing in price. If you find one of these at a local sale, you can negotiate a little bit. It didn't have a lens on it, so I can negotiate a little bit. He knew what he had. He just wanted to move it out of there anyway. So that's the kind of thing where I would highly recommend a Nikon FM. The FM2 is wonderful. The FM is really beautiful too. And you'll save a lot of money and put that money into film if you pick up an FM instead of the FM2. And with that 20mm lens, that's been a camera I've been carrying a little bit lately. I like it. It's a point and shoot. All right, that's today's photography talk. If you're enjoying these, hit the subscribe button. If you can support, hit the Patreon. Thanks so much to everybody who supports. And I will be back next week. We'll talk Leica or more gear talks. As always, here's the good light.